Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and I think this is, well, it might be common knowledge to you guys out there that this is one of my favourite guitars of all time. This is a Kramer Baretta. Personally, I owe a lot to this model of guitar, the Kramer Baretta. I wouldn't be here talking to you guys right now, and this wouldn't be my job if it wasn't for a Kramer Baretta in some incarnation over the years. Because when I was a kid, anyone who I looked up to all played Kramer guitars, and the Baretta was the flagship. Unfortunately, I missed the 80s as a kid. I was born in the 90s, but that music just latched onto me as soon as I heard it. I remember the first time seeing someone do something on TV, and I had no idea what they were doing it. They were using two hands, playing some of the fastest stuff in the world. It was always a Kramer. It was a Kramer first, and it was a Kramer till the end. Unfortunately, Kramer went away in the late 80s and came back in the 2000s. If you want to know more about that kind of crack, watch my video, 8 Facts You Probably Didn't Know About Kramer Guitars. But for now, let's talk about these beautiful new ones. And I say new, they're not exactly new. This is made in 2020, and it's not new because, well, I personally pride myself on having a little quirky collection of vintage Kramers, which I love dearly. And I have a few original Berettas from 84 to 1988, and I know them very well. When I pick up this, can't really tell the difference. Can't really tell the difference at all. So it is a new guitar, but it 100% faithfully recreates these iconic guitars from what I believe to be the most amazing time for music. And to look at, it's hard to believe how much an impact this simple guitar design would have on the guitar industry, on the music industry, on the world. It helped define a genre and a style which is still very prevalent to this day, and helped inspire some of our favorite artists. The Kramer Baretta came around in 1983, 1984, and it was the brainchild of this guy, and we all know what this guy got up to, an absolute legend who's missed every day. And if you want to honor him as if it was the early 80s, you have to play this stuff on a Baretta. Anyways, that's enough of me harping on about how much I love the brand and this guitar. Let's get into some hardcore specs, okay? Maple body and a beautiful three-piece maple neck, which fits beautifully under your hand. It's kind of like a modern C, but slightly thinner than you'd expect. This variant in ruby red also comes in pewter gray with a matching headstock and that old school Kramer logo right there. You've got a little toolkit on the headstock as well for the Floyd Rose system. Speaking of the Floyd Rose system, it's a Floyd Rose 1000, a system that lets you absolutely hammer the whammy bar on your beautiful Kramer, but it will stay perfectly in tune. It's got such a beautiful snap to it, obviously helped by the fact that the body itself is made of maple, and the bolt on maple neck just gives it a lovely brightness. The tone itself is coming from the fantastic open coil Zebra Seymour Duncan JB. The original Baretta's had Duncan JBs in, and the reissues do as well. It's utterly fantastic. And if you're wondering why it's slanted, because in the early 80s, in 1983, Big Eddie Van Halen was a huge fan of the Floyd Rose tremolo, and his latest incarnation had the fine tuners on, which he took from a violin. That's why they've got fine tuners on. But the string spacing was a bit too far apart to match the pole pieces. So to match the pole pieces of the pickup under the strings themselves, you had to slant it. And because of that, you get a more unique sound, because there's a bit more bass response on the low end and it's a bit more bright on the higher strings. It's quite a unique thing. And with it only being one pickup, you get the most pure sound you can out of your guitar, because there's no other magnets from other pickups pulling on the strings. Even when they're not activated, they are still pulling on the strings, but the magnet of this JB gets the pure Baretta tone. One simple volume control as well, which also doubles as a coil tap, so you can get some beautiful coil tap, single coil tones from the JB and the Baretta. What other specs are there? 14-inch radius fingerboard. It's quite a flat fingerboard, so perfect for chord work and when you want to get your shreddy shred on. The body itself is kind of like a slightly shrunken, more curved Stratocaster double cut design. It fits, it suits your body perfectly, whether you're sitting down or standing up. No problem getting to the higher frets. 22 frets, I might add, medium jumbo, 25.5-inch scale. That's the Baretta. We'll be right back. when you hit an A chord, you just have to do the, because it's just Eruption is dying to come out with this guitar. Copyright is a thing though, and I can't play that. I've just kind of got away with Dance the Night Away before. Such sustain. Signal chain wise, I probably should have mentioned earlier, I'm using two Atec cables into the Blackstar HT Stage 100 Watt Mark II head and cab, but you're hearing it not through a microphone, but through the Two Notes Torpedo Captor X, which is emulating, well, it's an IR of a Blackstar 4x12 going into your lovely ears. So I'll play some more dirt, and then some clean stuff. Let's hear some clean sounds on the clean channel of the amp. Funky with a Baretta. Back in the day, there wasn't really many two-channel amplifiers out there, and to get a clean sound out of your amplifier that was already cranked because it was the 80s, you just rolled the volume down on your guitar. It's just such a fun guitar to play. Under your fingertips, you just kind of flow to places you can't really flow to unless it says Kramer on the headstock. So that, ladies and gents, I believe is all the specs and sounds I can get out of the fantastic Kramer Baretta, because it is very versatile, but it has only got one pickup. And if you want to rock some Van Halen or Motley Crue or Dagan or any of the best music from the 80s, well, in my opinion, the best music of all time, you've got to get yourself to a PMT store and try one of these out for yourselves, because they are utterly remarkable. Any of the new Kramers are, like the Pacer, the Night Swan, the Stage Masters, the new Charlie Parrish signature, the Snake Sabo one, the douche from Skid Row has his own signature Baretta, the Tracy Guns Gunstar Voyager, of course, and many, many others. all each as fantastic as the last. Please comment down below your favourite Kramer guitar or Kramer player, or just how much we all love the 80s, because if you're watching this, I'm guessing you're an 80s fan as well. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music-related content. If you want any more information on the Kramer Baretta, get your fine self to pmtonline.co.uk or call into one of our forever expanding lovely PMT stores. We are PMT House of Rock on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of this guitar with nice filters on. I've been Dagan, and I'll see you next time.